All right, everybody, welcome back. Thanks for sticking with us this morning. This story, I kind of get why it's trending.
Yeah, but I'm excited to see it because I have not seen the picture.
Yeah, so check this out. We want to know what you think about it. Keke Palmer's boyfriend is getting a lot of heat online after publicly shaming her, commenting on her outfit, an outfit that she wore to an Usher concert recently. So this is also the father of her new baby. I think she looks fantastic.
Same.
Postpartum bod is shining. Darius Jackson, that's the boyfriend, responded to a video of her at the show with the caption, quote, "It's the outfit, ... you're a mom."
Nope.
Done and done. He doubled down later on Twitter. Palmer's fans were quick to come to her defense. Palmer herself is yet to publicly address those comments, but did go on and post more pictures of her own outfit, saying, quote, "I wish I'd taken more pictures."
What's up, y'all? Gerald here, creator of Gospel Chops and your host for this YouTube channel, back with another video. Now, this is an interesting one here. We have a Hollywood couple. Well, at least a Hollywood baby mama who had a baby by a man who is not as famous as she. We can assume that he is not as wealthy as she is, and he, before marrying her, implanted seed in her. She brought forth that seed, and now this brother is trying to flex husband privileges on a woman who he has not married. Well, who are we talking about? We're talking about Keke Palmer, who has now gone viral for a video she was captured in at an Usher performance where she had on a see-through dress showing off her mom cheeks, dancing and grinding up against Usher, singing along with him in a Hollywood-type performance. I can't remember when the last time Keke Palmer was this viral. So it obviously worked to a certain degree. But her baby daddy came out on social media and said, "Hey, that dress though, your cheeks out. You're a mom, what are you doing?" Well, the feministas of the internet, as they tend to do, they rallied behind Keke Palmer and said, "Boy, you can't tell her what to do. Who are you anyway? We don't know you. She makes all the money. She's the celebrity."
I just want to say, I don't know Keke Palmer's boyfriend. I don't know anything about him, really, besides the current thing. But let me just say, I hate that man. I pray and plot on his downfall. I hate him. I'm disgusted. I think when my friend told me that, we were just like sitting, and I was like, what? I would love the chance to like punch that. Like, who? I am appalled. No couth, not one drop of couth. Like, there's so many things wrong with it, but the. I just want to say, I don't know Keke Palmer's boyfriend. I don't know. Also, like, what did he think that we were going to say? Like, agree, and then we're going to what? Yell at your girlfriend and the mother of your child? Like, what did he think anyone was going to say? Like, yes, we're going to help. We're going to gang up on her with you. We don't know you. Also, what? It was unhinged the way the tweet. What did he think that we were going to do? Agree? Also, I thought the dress was amazing and so cute and elegant and like very, not that I even believe in there's a way that mom should dress, but I thought it was very like mom, new mom, sexy, night out. I thought it was very nice, but whatever. Did he think that we were going to agree? With him? Against Keke Palmer? It was never going to work.
At one angle, I can see where they're coming from. Because this brother failed in many regards. He didn't make her his wife in order to get that biblical support. In Titus 2, where the mothers of the church teach so much. Titus 2, verse 5. To be discreet, chaste, keepers at home, good, obedient to their own husbands, that the word of God be not blasphemed. Well, if you don't marry this woman and you don't put a ring on her finger, you have no rights to scriptures that support covenant. You're just a baby daddy. You don't even have the rights to stomp around the house because you haven't put this woman under covenant and made an honest woman of her. So what does she do? She does what she's always done. Plays to Hollywood. A woman that may have sold her soul to the game. She knows that this is how I make money, bro. Baby or no baby. Baby daddy or no baby daddy. This is how I'm used to making my coin. So for you to step out, and I understand why he did it publicly, because she did it publicly. At an Usher concert, he may be feeling some kind of way at watching the mother of his child grinding up against Usher and dancing in this half-naked outfit with your cheeks hanging out. These are now mom cheeks, and the boy is saying, you a mom now, stop doing this. Well, bruh, you haven't made a wife out of her, and yet you are trying to flex husband privileges. You ain't a husband. But what's interesting is that the feministas rallied behind Keke Palmer and try to encourage her to be defiant against her baby daddy. And I wonder, if he was in fact a husband, would they have this same energy? Would the feministas say, don't listen to this man? He can't control you. It's your body. Do with it what you will. Girl power. Well, they have that same energy if he had put a ring on her finger? We don't know because he hasn't done it. But is it asking too much for a brother to be able to assess his woman prior to marriage and make a determination as to whether she is the proper fit to be his wife, whether she will consider his instruction, if not obey his instruction? It seems to me that this brother may be putting this woman to the test and saying, maybe she's unfit to be a wife, because she out there for these Hollywood streets. She's willing to do whatever for the coin. She's willing to show her mom cheeks to the public. Something that should be sacred for the husband. Oh, but you ain't no husband. Let's not forget that. You are trying to flex in the husband's shoes when you haven't made that commitment to be the man that she needs. So maybe she's still looking. Maybe she's failing his test that he's putting her up to. Can you do these things before I put a ring on it, as Beyonce would say? 1 Peter 3:5 says, for after this manner in the old time, the holy women also who trusted in God adorned themselves, being in subjection to their own husbands. 1 Peter 3:7, likewise, ye husbands, dwell with them according to knowledge, giving honor unto the wife as unto the weaker vessel, and as being heirs together of the grace of life, that your prayers be not hindered. Well, the Bible speaks a lot on the husband-wife covenant, but it goes in another direction when addressing the baby mama issue or the baby daddy issue. A lot of people try to say, well, the Bible doesn't speak on baby mamas and baby daddies. Yes, it does. You are acting out of covenant. This is fornication. Fornication that has brought forth a life that in modern society complicates everything. Now we have to deal with issues of child support and visitation and access to parenting and income, support. These things, all things that don't benefit the child in most instances. It's a baby mama, baby daddy conflict. But what happens when in situations like this, you come into a moral conflict where baby daddy is looking forward and saying, what's going to happen when my child becomes of age and has to see their mama out here like this? What is going to happen when I teach my child one thing according to my values and they see photos and videos of their mama on the internet, these things that live forever? They see these videos of mama with her cheeks out grinding on Usher. Oh, Usher ain't my daddy. Is mama just out here for the streets? How should we treat this? These are legit considerations. However, they are legit considerations for a husband. This man, this boyfriend, this baby daddy doesn't have the rights to control this woman in modern society in the way that he is trying to, according to his social media accounts. Bro, you can't tell her what to do. You can't tell her what to wear. You can't tell her where to go because you're not her husband. How you gonna flex on husband rights when you haven't made a wife out of her? Seems silly. Seems simplistic that we should all understand this. From where do you derive the authority to tell this woman what to do and what to wear? Because you put a baby in her? Come on, man. This is why people are laughing at you on this internet. This is why people are mocking your position on this internet. If this was your wife, I'm sure the level of pushback would be far less than what it is now. But because you haven't made the commitment, sir, to wife this woman that you decided to lay down with, well, the feminists are dragging you, and perhaps rightfully so. You have valid points. You're a mom now. You shouldn't be out here shaking your tail feathers like this in public. I agree, but I disagree that you have the authority to speak over a woman that you have not made covenant with. Do you agree or do you disagree? Am I on point here or am I missing something? Like the video, subscribe to the channel and share the video so we can get more people involved in the conversation, yo. And like I always say, always remember and never forget, without the gospel, it's just chops. Until next time, peace.